Hey, how's it going? In this video, I'm going to show you how I'm extracting company names from a headline. This would be particularly useful if you're scraping some headlines from the internet or like news articles or blog articles, and you want to build a list based upon the company name. So basically, what you're doing is reverse engineering this. Instead of starting with the company name, you find an interesting article headline which features a company like this, for example, cyber startup Secura wraps up seed funding round. Maybe you want to contact Secura. If you've got a list of 1,000 headlines, it will take you ages to type in the company names to then build a data set. So what I'm doing here, I've trained GPT J to do this for me. And I'm hooking it up using Make, and I've used Riku to build a prompt using GPT J technology. I'm doing an HTTP request to glue the things together. So the prompt looks like this. So I'm basically telling GPT J what to do, and I've given it some scenarios. So you analyze the following sentence and you extract the company name. So here's the sentence. So Green Places secures 4 million in seed funding led by Felicis. And the company name is Green Places. So the extraction is done based upon the sentence. GPT J learns which bits to pull out, and then the response is sent back to here. So I've got my examples here. I've just grabbed these off Google quickly, and I've got Google Sheet set up. So I've got the sheet here, and this is monitoring this part here. From here, I've got an HTTP request, and I'm gonna have to blur some parts of this here. But what this is doing, this is just doing a JSON request, and it's sending the details to Riku from the Google Sheet input, and then it will bring it back into the spreadsheet. So it runs a little bit like this. If I choose where to start, if I do all, I've not tested this scenario on this for the YouTube tutorial, so hopefully it will work without me having to tinker too much. So if we do run once, let's see if it works. It should paste the names back into here, as opposed to the duplicate for some reason. Oh, I think I've got this set up on only do one at a time, which is no use. Let's do limit 10. If we run this again, we should see all of the names start coming back into here. I don't know why it's pasting it over here as well. I think I may have selected too many columns in Make. So as you can see, the power of this. Imagine you have like a list of 10,000 company headlines scraped from blog articles, and you want to quickly create a company name based upon the article headline for your outreach. You don't want to pay a virtual assistant, you don't want to do it yourself, as you've got better things to be doing. So get GPT J to do this for you. And you can see what that was literally seconds whilst we were talking. And the company names are done, and I think it's accurate. So we've got Younger Labs, Secura, and Highlight. Yeah, testing platform Highlight. This is a difficult one to extract actually, because Highlight is a normal word. It's not like a random company name like Younger Labs, which is very easy to identify. Mirror World is correct. MBOP, yeah, correct formatting as well, which is nice. New Earler, Sweater, Whistle. Yeah, it's understood that. Alter, armor code. So yeah, it is accurate. I'm not sure why it's pasting it in D. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, I've copied and pasted it twice, so this is why. So that shouldn't be in D. So if we were to do some more of these, let's just copy paste. It should all paste it back into the correct ones again. And we'll press run. It should start off from where we left. Yeah, here it goes. So imagine trying to do this one by one. I bet your GPT J is a faster typer than you and more accurate at making mistakes. Last one. Amazing. So yeah, that's done. I just thought I'd show you that quick vid. Feel free to steal this if you're building out in Riku, if you want to build it, but the options are limitless when it comes to AI. It's really powerful, especially as a lot more than writing blog articles, which seems to be the trend at the moment. So anything you can think of, you can pretty much ask AI to do for you, especially GPT J is really powerful. Test out Riku as well, it works really well, especially for calling between make and your data. Let me know what you think. If you've got any questions, yeah, drop me a message below. Cheers.